Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It's Friday. I know I missed last Friday, but that won't stop me this Friday. Dang it. And today we're going to be going over text string. This is something that I'm trying to learn more too. So it's not going to be a perfect video. We're just going to try out three different types of text string that you can do in Procreate. This is a video that's kind of teaching me, and I hope it teaches you guys, the viewers. And I also hope that it kind of opens the possibilities of Procreate to you if you haven't really tried it. I hope that this kind of gets you more into it. So first off, we're going to go over number one. I have this more pinky tone in here. It's like a pigment between orange and red. So it's just a simple color. I don't really know what I want to texture this with, but I thought I'd play around with some brushes. Right now I'm on the flat brush. It's a good texture brush, but it's not rough enough, so I'm going to go with this damp brush. I'm going to go ahead and make that a little bit bigger. I'm going to grab this color, I'm going to drop it to a darker shade, and I'm just going to like dab it in there and kind of create a texture. As you notice, this brush, it kind of flows back and forth. I don't know if you noticed that, but it kind of blends as you brush in. So you're kind of creating a texture and blending it at the same time. Let me grab a different layer here and I'll show you. So see, as if I go one direction, it fades, almost like it's running out of paint. It's a brush running out of paint. So even if you push harder, if you apply more pressure, it's still gonna run out of paint. So going back on it blends it, and you kind of just blend it as much as you want and muck it up. But that's the kind of brush we're using right now. It's a damp brush, so it's got some paint on it. I'm going to decrease my colors here and kind of throw them in, get some more textures in there, get this nice rustic texture going. Oops, I'm on the wrong layer. Does that happen to you guys? That happens to me way too much. That's okay. We're going to delete this ink layer. I don't really need it. Throw another one in there just in case I do. So again, going back to this, we're going to throw in those smaller details, kind of blend them in with this brush. I really like this brush. I'm glad I trying it today at this moment. It's got a nice feel to it. So I've got this nice texture going in. As you can see, it gives this really popcorn wall effect, you know, like your ceilings, or it looks kind of like something's peeling out, which is kind of cool effect. You could be applying this to some brick or some stone on a nice wall that you're painting. The nice thing about texturing is it shows you a lot. It shows you a lot of detail with minimal effort, which saves you more time. Not saying that that's the way you should paint. You should always put in maximum effort, but you should have a steady work pace. You shouldn't be getting hung up on little things. So just kind of learn to work around those and expand by moving faster and not draining yourself out on one little detail or getting a little bit too hung out on something. Just kind of find ways to make your mind think around problems. And it also helps you create a little bit more of a more developed piece by adding more texturing. This is what the professionals say, I don't know. I'm just kidding. You could be like one of those people that's like, art is subjective, which it is. So, yeah. So that's our first brush. I really like that texture. I think it looks very fun. That could be a good wall or... telling you, you can just make something really nice out of that. And maybe at the end of this, we'll go over a demonstration of how to apply a texture or something. I think we will, if I have time. I have to go pick up my girlfriend here in a little bit, and I wanted to squeeze this in today. Now on to step two. Not step two, but number two. I'm gonna keep that color. I really like it. It's very nice, pretty blue. Let's try this flat brush. By the way, I'm using just these painting brushes today. This is my favorite column of brushes. I use them for most of my paintings. This jagged brush up here is one of my favorites, and same with the flat brush. Those are the ones I prefer the most. Now, the oriental brush is very nice for creating bushes and stuff. If you like to do landscape, it puts out a really nice texture. But we're going to actually try this dry brush and then the flat brush on this blue. So go ahead, and I'm going to grab the flat brush for the darker tones. I just think it will come across a lot better. I'll drop that and exaggerate that color very dark. And this brush also has that blending effect feature. I really like that. That's kind of how I learned to do digital art, was with brushes like this. So I'm a little bit biased to these brushes, but that's just my opinion, you know. Let's switch over to the dry brush for some highlights. Create a nice... Ooh, I like this texture. It's almost like a marble. Like something scratching, like scratched it. Very cool. And it also blends. It has that blending feature. If you go back across it, it's going to blend it out. So very cool. Gives it a really cool scratched effect. And we could probably even apply this to the darker tones to give it other features. Look at that. And some nice creases in there. It almost looks like fur now at this point. Or like cat hair, I don't know. If you have a cat, poor people, I pity you. I'm just kidding. Cats are fun. And the cats, for the most part. Look at that. That brush added some nice highlights to the other side. Gave it a really, really complimentary of... Oh, man, my words today are just a mess. I think number two looks really good. That's all I'm saying. Those textures are just popping at me. Wow, look at them. So cool. Okay. Now on to number three. This one looks like more of a fleshy tone, so let's try more flesh brushes. That sounds weird, but hey, it's art. So the flat brush would honestly work pretty well for a skin texture if you were really close on a person's face. which, you know, some people draw very detailed ways, so that's a good way to throw in a lot of detail, you know, small. With the least amount of worry or effort. There's better ways to terminology? I don't know. There's better ways to say what I'm saying, but I can't say it because I'm bad at English. But, bear with me. Ooh, this rad brush works very good for leaves, by the way. Falling on the ground, like if you're trying to create like a fall setting. So I'm trying to look for a brush that would really work for a skin. Oh, look at this. Rough skin. Zombie skin. Why not? Let's try it. Drop it to a more pigmented tone. There we go. I don't know. Somewhere in between there. That's a nice color. Let's go more red. There we go. And we're going to add some texturing in. Sorry, my phone went off. Apologies. Alright, let's try this out. This brush is not doing anything. Oh, yes it is. Wow, it's just really zoomed in. Okay. I can work with it. Alright, that looks like some good zombie skin effects. It's really adding a nice texture, honestly. I don't really get a zombie skin effect from it. If you blend it in, you can really make it look kind of interesting. That's another thing to really focus on when you're using texturing. Don't forget to blend in certain areas, make it look a little bit softer. You don't want all your textures running into everywhere. You want to blend some of these in to make them look like they just flow out of what they're in. Just to give them a simpler effect. That's why these two, number one and number two, were very nice brushes, because they also blended as you painted, kind of helping you do the work as well. So, back to this one. Let's go for a highlight. Let's move it up to more of this side and add in skinnier highlights over here. Skin highlights up here. Yeah, there we go. Bam. I don't like this one. Let's just change it. Let's try old skin. What's that look like? You guys know what old skin looks like? It apparently looks like a basketball. That looks gross. So, look at this. We have a nice lizard effect going here. If we just kind of blotch in some interesting textures into some areas, like that, building some nice textures. But overall, I think this demonstrates a very nice layout of what you can achieve in Procreate. Think of the things you could apply this to. Simply like clothes, buildings, and most of texturing of what you want to do for something. So let's grab both of these layers since I have them together, and we're going to drag them up to the top here. I should have zoomed out before I did that, but that's okay. And go ahead and fix these a little bit. Bam. move this guy down closer. Cool. Awesome. Oh, oops, I don't want to grab it. There we go. Weird thing about Procreate is if you kind of go off the edges a little bit, it'll take away, like, your lines sometimes. Really weird, but I don't know why, like, if you select it, and then you move it, and then you unselect it, it'll get rid of it. Like, I don't know if I can turn that off, because I don't like it when it does that. So, because if you do that, and then you pull it off, it's gone. But it doesn't matter, pish posh. It's, you can just control Z it away, or double tap. Sorry, back to it. After I've cleared my image, I'm going to go to here. I'm going to do like a little demonstration of what we could really apply this to, and I'm going to use example number one for my texturing and what I kind of want to do for a texture, or what it could be applied to. So we're going to draw like a, let's see, kind of want to draw like a little engine that, or a tractor would work very well in this instance. Because this thing gives me more of a rustic vibe. So I kind of want to keep that in mind when I'm doing this. I definitely want to make this apply to something that it definitely makes sense to apply to. You know, I feel like that's not too hard to ask for. Sorry, I'm taking a moment to look up a better reference picture for a tractor, just so that I can kind of get the idea of what I'm drawing here. First off, since we don't have a lot of time, I'm going to make, just go by a little bit quicker, and I'm going to select and make this image just a little bit of time, and rough it in. So this is my tractor. I don't personally have a tractor. My dad has a tractor. It's pretty cool. I've had to drive it a couple times, not to brag. Am I the best at it? No. But do I like to drive it? Yeah, dude. It's a tractor. Come on. Sorry. Back to the subject at hand. We're going to apply these colors to my tractor here. And I know it looks a little bit rough right now, but that's okay. It's supposed to look that way. And we're going to put alpha lock on this, just because I don't really want to take too much time and draw around all this. So I'm going to block in our colors here and make them kind of pop here. Do it to there. Give us a nice black color. Throw that in there. And this is a pretty rough tractor, but don't worry, I'm going to make it look a little bit better here in a second. And we're going to throw in some darkness to right there. I can see I'm using this flat brush, and it's already creating a bit of a texture. It's really kind of giving it like a chalky look, which is fine because it's going to work out in the end. That's kind of what I'm going for. So working in textures can really save you time later on, and also build on your piece and make it look a little bit more not put together, because a painting can look good put together without detail as well, as long as it's well structured. Sorry, I got really focused. Alright, we're just going to blend that just to kind of save some time again, because I want minimal details here, but I also want to really make it come across that this is a tractor. Because it's not cool when it's not a tractor. Or when your tractor looks weird, I guess. I don't know. Alright. So this is my tractor. And it looks really bad. But if this is my tractor, this alpha lock's actually kind of working against me, so I'm just going to take that back off. Thought I could use it, because I like using it, but just because I like using it doesn't mean it works out all the time. Draw this. And right now I'm using, I don't know if you watched my technique video, but I'm using the sculpting technique. I'm kind of just sculpting away my image here and really building it in. I'm also doing it with color just to save a little bit of time. While doing this, I'm keeping in mind shading. Obviously, things farther away are going to have a darker color, or up here to fall into the background a little bit more. Let's just shade this away. My voice keeps on like chirping, like kind of cracking, but it's not cracking. I don't know if you can catch it in there, but you are now. So here we are. Draw a little seat for my dude to sit in there, because you always need a little seat to sit in when you're doing your tractor and stuff. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know what I'm saying. Awesome. So this is our tractor here. It's looking pretty smexy. You know, you've heard this song. If you haven't, sorry. I don't know what to tell you. It's a good song, I think. I don't know. People used to like it, at least, I thought. Things change so quickly anymore. Bam. All right. That's so nice. And also, when you're drawing in this way, if you're using the blocking method of drawing, try to think of the simple rule of big, little, small. Just try to keep that in mind as you're doing stuff like this. I'm trying to keep that in mind. Sometimes I don't. That's okay. We're not perfect, but we try. Sizing. Like bring this in tight, make it look like an engine. Giving this nice texture using this flat brush in various ways. Kind of simply pressing in, just trying to use it as my tool to show a little bit of texture on things that are a little bit more shiny and flat. But if I'm going for a low decal detail, and I want things to appear with lower detail, but have a nice look to them, I want to have them well textured and blocky, so that you can get the idea of what they are. At this point, I've set down my reference photo because I just kind of stopped looking at it. And I'm winging it now, so maybe that's why this is going a little bit rougher. I just had to remember what they kind of look like because it's been a minute since I've seen the tractor. So, there's the guilty truth. But I remember enough. So now that we got our tractor mainly pretty set up here, let's go ahead and add that texturing to it, because by this point you know it's a tractor. I've said tractor more than enough times to know that it's a tractor. Because sometimes believing is most of it. Not really. Yes, it is. I don't know. I'm talking a lot. So I'm going to go in and add these real quick, just because I'm really enjoying this. So just bear with me. I think maybe you guys are too. If not, that's okay. Stay tuned for next season. It'll probably get better as I progress. Whatever. We're going to go on to texturing. I got to go pick up someone soon, and I don't want to run out of time. But I wanted to do the video, so I'm doing it, because I have time, and editing takes a while, so that's okay. We'll get it all done and figured out. So I'm going to go back to that damp brush. That was the first one I used on there, and I'm going to make it a little bit bigger, and at this moment, I'm going to put an alpha lock on it, just so that everything doesn't drag off the edge, you know? I'm going to throw those details in there. I'm going to make the bottom a little bit more dark. I'm going to move it on up here. Make this a little bit bigger, just to kind of show that the metal's like rustic, but you know, rusty. And a good thing to also do is lower that opacity on that brush. That'll also help out if you have a heavy hand or You just really don't want that too strongly on there. As you can see, as I applied it to this surface, it really showed up quickly. As I blend that back in, we're gonna go ahead and go to the top of this. And throw in some of those highlights up here as well. Give it like a nice texturing. I'm having a rough time with this drawing. That's okay. By the way, the last Friday, the reason I didn't, I'm gonna switch back to this flat brush. I kinda wanna get that texture that I had back. But the reason I didn't make a video last Friday is I just kinda, wasn't feeling the best, didn't really have the time. I was having a bad art day. I sat down, I tried to make a video, but everything I was drawing just wasn't working. So I had to take a break. I was like, this isn't my day. That's okay. Because now I'm back and I'm doing this, and it's coming along a lot better. We're showing some textures off. I should have just drawn a cat, but that would have been the easy way out. I chose a piece of industrial, and I don't draw industrial things very often. But that's totally okay, because I'm kind of having fun drawing it and demonstrating how you can just kind of rough it textures and show some true gusto, you know, if that's something you want to show. Lower this, and we're gonna make a little detail up here to so that kind of disappears, bam. The nice thing about this flat brush is it's easy to control, and it also puts down a decent amount of work for you, and showing some nice details and texturing. The bad thing about this brush is that it has a little bit of too much of a fade to it. So once you lay down a color, if you go back over it, it'll make it darker and darker, which can work in your benefit, but it can also get a little bit irritating for me. I don't particularly like it when my brushes do that. I just want to be able to press harder and lay all the color down. I don't want to, because I am a pretty heavy-handed person, I want to be able to just lay it down, and then I'll work on blending it later, you know? But I'm sure in the settings you can fix that. Everything's fixable in brushes, so keep that in mind. I should keep that in mind as well. Yeah, last Friday wasn't really working out for me, so today is the day that I am doing it. So I hope you guys are enjoying it, because it's going pretty good, huh? I told you you'd be back for more videos. You didn't believe me, but here we are. See, I got some nice textures coming in here as I zoom back in here and sharpen up the image a little bit more, build it a little bit more. It's nice to kind of throw in textures at the beginning as well to really build on something and kind of, know, use it to your advantage as you go in with more details. Sorry for the motorcycle jerk outside. I live in apartment buildings now, so I apologize, it's not always quiet, but I enjoy making the videos again, so I'm gonna keep doing it. There we go. As you can tell, we got some nice textures up here. If we make this one a little bit bigger and we grab some darker ones, we can select a certain area of this part of the little truck here. Pull it over to here. And then we can grab this brush and make it a little bit bigger and just kind of brush in some fake texturing. Make it kind of look like it's got paint going across the top of it. Just take that off and oops, my screen stopped working for a second. Yeah, there we go. And there you go. Yeah, this nice little effect of it going across the top of a faded paint job. And again, I'm still learning, so I apologize. This may not be up to what you guys are usually used to seeing, but c'est la vie. Such is life, right? Ooh, that's dark. That's not the color I want. I want like this color. Oh my goodness, what? I must have deselected somehow. Does that ever happen to you guys? It happens to me. This is looking like a pretty fresh tractor, if I do say so myself. Oops. For some reason, my dad's tractor tires always have red in them. For some reason, I don't know why. There's just always a red tire on the outside of it. Got ourselves a pretty good tire going there. Now, if we apply number two, we can take number two here, grab the colors. We actually just change them to a softer greenish kind of color. Go ahead and grab the brushes that I had before that we were playing with. Flat brush here. Make it a little bit smaller. I'm going to just throw that in underneath. Add a texture. Because I'm curious to see if this will make it look more like grass if we just kind of let it flow down here. So you can see applying texture really kind of changes the game of what you're making. It can really increase something or decrease it dramatically if you have the wrong combinations of something, I guess. And then we're going to just brush this one in an upward motion. Get that nice grass effect. Kind of looks like it's coming around the tractor and stuff underneath. Kind of build it up around the tires. Remember that there's a tire down there, you know? So light's going to stop and hit that tire. Because black's isn't it? Oh man, words are just tough for me, guys. I apologize. It'll get better eventually as I keep talking. Or it won't. I never know. But remember where your highlights are going to show is where the light's hitting, mainly. And also where you don't have things going into the grass. Where to be super accurate with this, our darker spots should be where our tires are. Again, because light's going to really pull towards black. Or I guess black is very absorbent. It'll absorb that color. So looking at it from a distance, we would see that the tire continues to go down to the ground. Or if it was really thick grass, I guess it wouldn't show very much, right? Give this texture brush. We can just kind of move it around the canvas to make it look like our canvas is starting to end here too. And the powers of texturing. Right on. There you go, you have yourself a nice setting for a tractor by applying just some simple brushes. I'm not going to use this skin one because I don't really want to go over those ones. Skin is kind of fun. This one looks like a reptile. If I was curious, let's try it. Let's see what we can do with it. You know, we could put something weird on here. Let's actually go back to this flat brush. Make it a little bit smaller. Sorry for the messages, I apologize again. Put in this red tire seat. And just by kind of dragging this brush around and lightly pressing, kind of smoothing things out too, that if they don't really appeal with you, just smooth them out. Throw in some more texturing. You can really start to build your image and build your sense of texturing and make it look like there's properties happening that aren't really happening. You're adding these small little details that you might think don't really matter, but as you can see, they do matter, and they can impact it in a great many ways. And they can also impact it in a better way. They can also add so much more to your artwork and make it look so much more interesting or more detailed or more of what you're probably trying to go for. At least what I'm trying to go for. Let's see, I'm trying to find the right effect for mud, because I want to add a nice mud texture across the bottom of here. Those seem like they always are. Interesting. Looks like they come out like that on there, but not interesting. I guess it's because they're water flakes, that might explain. Let's try this divine snow. That could be something. Oh yeah, that works very nicely. Got some nice mud textures here. These tractors are very muddy. Lower the opacity. Boom. And then we have a nice little tractor chilling with only a couple simple textures added to make it go the further step. Now it's time to just add the smaller details to really build and sell what we've been sculpting here, what we've been cooking up with our textures. At least that's what I'm going to do next. Add in these smaller details, just kind of the indentations, highlights. And we'll go ahead and bring this up a little bit. Add this nice metal texture to it. It's got the sun kind of radiating through this area. And it's interesting because most tractors have kind of an empty spot right here where you can just kind of see through them. At least my dad's did. They always had little spots that weren't really connected. And now we're just gonna add a couple wires in there to make it look like there's some wires going around and stuff. Boom! Got some nice little wires going through there. Up here by the steering, we're gonna rough this in a little bit better. Make this brush a little bit bigger, rough that in a little bit better. I don't really know what this is. Tractors don't have this, so I've been like trying to make that thing work like it's some futuristic tractor. They don't have that. I mean, some do, but they have a box on the top that connects it. I just don't know what was happening there. I wanted to keep it. Again, not looking at references can sometimes hurt you. I pull them up, I just drift off when I look at it. I just, you know, look at it and I'm like, yeah, okay. Then I won't really apply it, but I'm starting to do better at applying these things. Just like now, I looked over and I'm like, yeah, I guess that's not there. Go ahead and add a darker side to this just to kind of pull it back in again. This nice fleshy tractor color here. And we're gonna make this just be black right under here. can't really see what's going on under there. We'll take our tool here and just smooth it. And again, I'm sorry, I got really quiet there. I just got really focused. Hopefully you can hear the music in the background that kind of took up for my absence as a voice. I just got really into that. So I apologize. I don't know if you guys ever drift off. It's also really weird trying to talk and make a video. Because I don't talk to myself very often when I'm alone. Maybe in the car or something to like hype myself up, but... And again, that's pretty weird. I shouldn't be judging other people. I guess I should say that it's weird to talk to yourself to try and describe things because you don't do that very often. You don't sit in a room and you're pretending that other people are there. I guess if you're crazy, you can do that. But you know what I mean, right? Like you don't do that very much, and it's just kind of... kind of funny, but I'm getting more used to it, so it's making it a little bit easier to talk to myself. Alright guys, I think we're about to wrap this one up too, because I'm starting to end this, and I think all my textures are really pulling together here. And you can see we pulled out quite a couple different ones, just to kind of try some new things, and I think they work pretty well. So, if this opened up your eyes a little bit more to Procreate and the fundamentals and the things you can try in it, awesome. If it didn't, I apologize. Hopefully the next video will. I want to thank everyone for watching these, for the people that do at least. And I also want to take this moment to remind everyone, I know that these videos aren't the best videos, but I enjoy making them. This is kind of a hobby, and I hope it goes somewhere. Maybe it will, maybe it won't. But I think it's fun, and I hope you guys are enjoying it, those of you that are watching, and I appreciate that you are watching. I think that's awesome. Go ahead and saddle up for next Friday, because that should be coming up really soon here. So at least I hope so. That's when I get paid. It's Friday. God. Why is it always Friday? Every day I'm over here, it's Friday. I wish it was like Wednesday, so it could be midweek, and you feel good about it. You're like, midweek, okay. Alright guys, I think that's just going to do it. Today's episode about texturing. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope this helped in the best ways.